very white.
In tabu kapsa.
But the minute a dot of mud drops on it.
Lakini tangu kiria egenti ingosaga siki kala yikuni.
A dot of mud.
Aga tone kisiki.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It becomes soil.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And if you are a very serious person,
hautafurahia
kuenda na hiyo nguo katika sherehe ambayo ni ya maana.
Toko mokana kuenda usini umuyiga wingi
nchulia ni hiyo kwa hata ikamubimu uondoe hiyo nguo
pati kumitrili usi hangi hiyo
badlishe
on churini
ama usafishe
usiega toniki usunye siyo.
So in our spiritual life, although we are blessed, and as we saw last evening, the Lord was helping us, that we are blessed, in fact, according to the word of God. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, from verse 2 to almost that 12 there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are so blessed. Everywhere we are thoroughly blessed. But the truth is, thereafter in Deuteronomy 28 from verse
14
to the end. From 14 there to the end. You find curses. And they are not curses from your enemy. Ama your brother. Ama your father. They are direct curses from God. Hallelujah. So God tells us of blessings. And how we will be blessed and remain blessed.
Hallelujah.
He also tells us of curses and tells us why we can be cursed. So God is a wonderful Father, a wonderful teacher, who does not leave us in darkness. But allows us to see what is wrong. So that we can understand what has gone wrong. But I
say
sifa. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
God does not miss his words. In Deuteronomy 28, when he says why we will be blessed, he told the children of Israel, the word has not changed. For you is out there, for us who are in here, whether we know it or don't. He says in verse 2, and all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. So why will you be blessed? Because of your obedience to God. Why will I be blessed? Because of my obedience to God. Why would we be blessed even as a nation, as a community, as a family? Because of our obedience to God. So God makes it very clear that he has set forth the word. The word of God. Which is a manual to all mankind whom he has created. And he has taken time to tell us what will be good for us. And what would actually ensnare
us.
He has told us what would be beneficial to us. And what would bring doom to us. The word he has given us tells us
of the benefits of knowing him. The benefits of loving him. The benefits of loving his children. The benefits of understanding his word and meditating on that word. And so much. But also the word tells us and shows us examples of people, the consequences of disobedience, which is sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you may say, why am I going with this? We read that God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. And like in the morning, the Lord was helping us to actually